I am in a silhouette studio and thought that I would share with you how I'm making some Christmas in July designs. So I took and I just wrote these words out in the Adori Charlie font. Sorry, I'm gonna have to for the words. But I wanted to make some snowflakes with this. And I'm just trying to figure out how. So I went and looked at some snowflakes. I was like, oh, well, they're made by using arrows. So if I just take some arrows and go, let's see, let's make this skinnier like that. Just get rid of any lines around it. I don't want no lines around it. And let's just make it blue, right? And then take the object and convert it to a path. Oh, I created another one I didn't want to. Let's just undo that. There you go. Go up here to the pointer. Arrow. Let's take this. Take that one. Let's object. So you can say rotate it, or I can just say mirror it vertically. And there we go. All right, so I'm going to take that like that. But I need a center point, so we can just take this diamond and have it be our center point. Actually, we have no red line, and I want the color to be blue. And I want to make this object convert it to a path. I want to get my pointer out. And so that's going to be my pointer point there. And I'm going to take this. And I'm going to come over here to my points, because I don't want that to be quite that long on there. Just about like that. Duplicate that one. Oh, come on. Alright, I made a button on my computer to see if I can't get it where I want it easier. I don't want them crisscrossing over each other. There we go. So take that like that. And then let's get me a circle. That's a little circle. And let's make that circle the same blue. Make sure that we have no lines. Put that circle right there. Move this out of the center here for a minute. I'm gonna take this. Just gonna move it down. Just a little like that. I'm gonna select all of them. I'm gonna make sure that they are converted to a path. Come on. There we go. And blend this one up that way. Just over a little so you don't see the other part sticking out. And then actually, instead of that circle, I'm gonna duplicate this triangle. Just make it smaller for the diamond, not triangle. And you just gotta just like that. Just gonna put it right there. And then we come along, and I'm going to select all of those, and I'm going to weld it. I'm going to go Object, Modify, Weld. And I'm going to make it a little smaller. And then I'll take that, and I'm going to duplicate it. And I'm going to say Object, Mirror, so vertically, and I'm going to bring it right here. And I'm going to duplicate that one. And I'm going to rotate it by 90 degrees. And I'm going to stick it right there. And then I am going to duplicate that. And then I'm going to mirror it horizontally. And I'm going to bring it right here. And I'm going to hold that key. And I'm going to hold this one. And I'm going to come up here to Object. And I'm going to go Align. Top. That way they're even. And this one. And my Shift key is like that one. And I'm going to align those to the right. That way they're aligned together. They're exactly where I want them on the diamond. So I'm going to take this one, and I'm going to duplicate it, but I'm going to move it over here for a minute. Because now what I'm going to do, I'm going to get rid of this circle over here for a second, and move this completely out of the way, and I'm just going to come in here and go like this. I'm going to go Object, Convert to Path, Object, Modify, and I'm going to weld it together. There we go. Right here. Now that's going to be a really big snowflake, but let's make this up. Oh, I don't have to go like that. Let's go undo so that it's exactly undone. All right, now we'll bring it in like that. I'll make it smaller. I'm going to curve it a little like that. A little bit more like that. I'm just gonna bring it in like that. Then I'm gonna duplicate it. Then I'm gonna to mirror it horizontally. And mirror it right there. And then duplicate that. Object. Mirror. Flip vertically. Bring it right here. And then I'm gonna duplicate that. Object. Mirror. Flip horizontally. And I'm gonna move it right here. I'm gonna take this guy and move him right here. And take this one and move it right about there. So I'm happy with it. I'm going to come up like this. That way it selects all those. Make sure they're a path. And I'm going to modify and weld. Okay. And then I'm going to do an offset. So then I'm going to come up here and I'm going to go offset. And I'm going to go First, I'm going to make it white. Then I'm going to get rid of the red line. I'm going to duplicate that. I'm going to make that smaller. Nope, can't make that smaller, so we're going to take that one. Maybe that. We can make it smaller. Just have it be a single snowflake. Ugh, come on. You can't really see it, see? That's going to be really tiny to cut, though. But anyway, we can have that there. But we're going to select these two. We're going to make sure that they are a half. And then we're going to come and we're going to select just this one, and we're going to go internal offset. We're going to just make that white. Just like that. Give another red line. Object, convert to a path. And I'm just going to come along right here like this, select them all. And we're going to go object and group. And I can just make that small as I want, or as big as I want, and I got a snowflake. It's not really intended to be a small snowflake. The more I make these, the better at it. This is the first time I tried making this. There's my very first snowflake, y'all. Let's bring this word to the forefront. Object, arrange to the front. You guys get the gist of what I'm trying to do here. This circle can be gone. Get rid of that. Then we're going to go File, Save As to Hard Drive, and we're going to save it as an SVG, and we're going to call it 'Tis the Season to be Freezing Snowflake. And we're going to go OK. Why? There is no design store content. Where is the design store content? Say OK. There's not one design store content in that. Let's make sure it's in Screw Art thing. Let's go Cricut. And let's go Upload. Upload image, rounds, pictures, SVG by me, open it up, looking for SEA, no RST, is the season to be freezing, open that up, there we go, and we're going to write by me, and say upload, and we're going to take that, and we're going to add it to our canvas, and we're going to ungroup it. Now, on Cricut, we can change the color of our canvas so we can actually see what the heck we're doing. There we go. So there we go. So if I want to make snowflakes now to hang around my house, I can. I don't have to worry about, I don't have design space or anything. Not that it's ever going to be season to be freezing around here or anything, but I'm duplicating my little snowflakes here, because I think they're kind of cool. Let's give it an offset. Offset. Now, that's where I can't see this. Let's change this color to a light gray. So maybe we can see when we're doing an offset. Offset. You gotta wait. You gotta wait. When it says apply, then there'll be an offset there. It's never gonna let me. Let's go silhouette and close that. Close it. Nope, I already have the SVG saved. I don't save it. Alright, let's make the offset smaller. Let's wait and see. Once it shows up green, it'll show up where it's at. Gotta wait for it. Gotta wait for it. There we go. Say apply. But I don't want it black. Let's make it the same blue color. There we go. And then select both of these. And if you want to print and cut, you would just flatten it. But I want to group it. So I'm going to come right here, and I'm going to go group. And then look, there we go. And I'm going to arrange that to the back. Not backwards, to the back. I'm going to get rid of that one. And I'm going to get rid of this one. I've uploaded it, so it's still in Cricut, but I'm going to duplicate that. I'm going to wait a minute, because it should show up somewhere on here as duplicated. Well, where is it duplicating it at? It says it did it, but I don't see it. Let's zoom out. Maybe it's here somewhere, I just don't see it. Oh, because I keep grouping it, guys. Duplicate it, Linda. There you go. Arrange that to the back. There we go, we got that. Arrange to the back. We got this one here. Let's go down to the offset that we created in, and we can change that to white. To white. Because it's an SVG that we've uploaded, we can change it to whatever we would like it to be. And wait, there we go. So there we have it, y'all. That is how to create snowflakes that look like the ones I created in Silhouette Studio and then add it to your Cricut. Let's just save it as Season 2B Freezing. There you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed that video. And hit the like button.